are continuing with our exploration of scale variables. I've already showed you how to get histograms, stem and leaf plots, PP plots, and box plots using various descriptive statistics commands. We are going to dive deeper into exploring scale-level data with charts that you can build in the SPSS Chart Builder. IBM SPSS Statistics software gives you multiple ways to create and edit charts. As we've already seen, you can edit and create charts in the Frequencies dialog box. For this example, we're going to use the Chart Builder to create a more complex chart. Now, last time, we used the Means command to create a bar chart for average income for different levels of job satisfaction. Now we will build the same chart using the Chart Builder. From the menus, choose Graphs, Chart Builder. The Chart Builder is a dialog box with interactive canvas that allows you to preview how the chart will look when you create it. Now, the chart that you see will not look exactly like the one that gets built, but it's a reasonable approximation. This is important to note if you are working in a classroom setting. Although you are using exactly the same variables, your canvas will not look like the canvas of the person working next to you. Your final graphs, however, will be the same. In the gallery, we see the variety of charts that are available. Bar charts are typically selected by default. We see that there are 8 types of charts listed in the category of bar charts. The icons give you information about what the chart will look like. If you need to know the name of a particular chart, hover your cursor over the icon to see its name. Drag the icon for simple bar chart into the canvas. The Chart Builder will show you a preview of what the chart might look like on the canvas. The preview chart, however, is not ready to print, and the OK button is still unavailable. We need to put variables into this graph. Both the x-axis and the y-axis have drop zones in which you can place variables. You do not necessarily need a variable for both axes, as we will see in a moment. To create a bar chart, we want to put our categories on the x-axis, and the y-axis will show us how much of something is in that category. We're going to use job satisfaction on the x-axis. This variable was measured on a 5-point Likert scale, which runs from very dissatisfied to very satisfied. For our purposes, we want to treat job satisfaction as a categorical variable. As you can see by the ruler icon, job satisfaction has already been classified as a scale variable. No problem, we can change that here. Right-click on job satisfaction in the variables list and choose ordinal. Job satisfaction is an ordered category. Being very dissatisfied is lower in this variable than being very satisfied. Now drag job satisfaction into the x-axis drop zone. The y-axis is automatically set to the count statistic. This will tell us how many people are in each of the 5 categories of job satisfaction. You will also notice that the OK button is now available, so click OK. In the output window, we see the number of people in each category. The counts look fairly similar across the categories. There's no real pattern. Well, that's good as far as it goes, but honestly, we could have done the same thing in the Frequencies dialog box. What would be more interesting to know is the average income for each category of job satisfaction. Return to the Chart Builder. As with previous analyses, our variables are still in the Chart Builder just as we left them. This time, drag income from the variables list to the y-axis drop zone. We already have a categorical variable on the x-axis. When we add a scale variable to the y-axis, the drop zone defaults to the mean statistic. Click OK. We can now see that income is strongly related to job satisfaction. Those who are highly satisfied have a much higher mean income than those who are highly dissatisfied. This is a much more useful chart. But there are still plenty of things we could do to improve it. Go back to the chart builder. We have a great many options available to us in the element properties window to improve on this chart. Now the element properties window should be open by default, but if it is not, you can open it by clicking here. The element properties window allows you to change the properties of various chart elements. We can change the type of bars in a bar chart, or the axes on the chart. We can change elements for individual bars. We can see that bar 1 is selected as being available to edit. Bar 1 refers to the first type of bar in the category. So in this case, these are all part of bar 1. The statistics drop-down menu shows us which statistics are available. Typically, the same statistics will be available for every type of chart. We could choose median income, or maximum, or even sum. This can be very useful in certain cases where you want to add up totals within a category. But then we have some other options. We could display a percentage greater than a given criteria, such as a poverty line. Or we can work within ranges. We can report on the variability, or the standard deviation. If you choose one of the options with a question mark, you get a new button called Set Parameters. Here, you can set a value that makes sense in your data. Now we, however, are just going to leave it set for the mean. Another important feature in the Element Properties window is the display of error bars. Error bars give us confidence intervals around the mean, but they can also be set to display the standard error or standard deviation. Sometimes you want to use two standard deviations as your comparison for whether two means differ. You can set that here. Whenever you make changes in the Element Properties window, it is very important that you apply those changes. If you don't, they will not show up. So click Apply. Notice the changes in the canvas. We can also edit the x-axis and the y-axis here. Click on x-axis. Here, the axis label is job satisfaction. Perhaps we would want to change that to job satisfaction category. If our categories were wrongly ordered, we could fix that by changing their direction here. Or even change it on a granular level by reordering answer options. Be sure to click Apply. For the y-axis, the label is mean household income in thousands. We could change that to average income. We could also rescale the data to present the logarithmic mean, if you are into that sort of thing. Again, click Apply. Click on footnote 1. We can make any adjustments that we like. Error bars show 95% confidence interval. Apply. Those are some of the changes that we can make with the element properties. We can also add titles and footnotes to the chart. Select the Titles Footnotes tab. We want to add a title. The title appears in the canvas with the label T1. In the element properties window, select Title 1 in the element properties list. In the content text box, type income by job satisfaction. This is the text of the title that will display. Click Apply to save the text. You will not see the text displayed in the canvas, but it will be on your finished chart. Click OK to build the bar chart. The bar chart shows us that participants who are more satisfied with their jobs tend to have higher household incomes. We could also interpret that as people who have higher incomes like their jobs more. Although this chart is useful just the way that it is, we can improve upon its appearance. For example, we could clean it up to match APA style. To edit the chart, double-click anywhere on the bar chart. This will open the chart editor and the accompanying properties window. APA style requires that the background be white and that we remove the box around the entire chart. Click on the gray background. In the properties window, fill and border should now be selected. The color of the fill and the border can be changed here. We want neither of them. Click to change the fill to none and the border to none. The red slash means none. Click apply. Now that is a great start, but we really need to do something about those ugly honey mustard colored bars. Double click on any one of the bars. APA style calls for grayscale rather than color. We will change the bar color to a medium gray. Click apply. We already know that the income is in US dollars. We could add a dollar sign to each of these categories. Click on the numbers in the y-axis. In the Properties window, click on the Number Format tab. For leading characters, type a dollar sign. Change the decimals to zero. For trailing characters, type a capital K. This Trailing Characters box is also where you could apply a percent sign to percentages, if that was what your values were displaying. Click Apply. I can also make changes to footnotes directly in the chart editor. For instance, I know that the comment about the error bars should be included in a note beneath the table figure in APA style. So I will remove it here. I will also remove the title because I think that should be included in an APA style title beneath the table later on. And now that I think about it, I think that I just want to label the x-axis as job satisfaction, after all. I don't need the word category. There is no apply button when you edit directly in the chart editor. To save your changes, just close the window. To get this chart ready to use in a paper or on a poster, I will export it to Microsoft Word. Although you can create charts for data screening in various descriptive statistics commands, the Chart Builder gives you dramatically more control over the appearance of your chart or figure. Regardless of what type of scale data you have, you should explore your data before using it. And you should strive to display your data honestly so that we can all learn something valuable from them.